We are here in Chennai at the Novotel Chennai Sipcot.
Today we basically for the lunch we are doing the Chennai cuisine.
I love this. This is absolutely fresh. Good morning, Prabhakar. How are you doing this morning?
Good morning, sir.
Thank you firstly for, you know, agreeing to come to Kovalam with me and being my guide. Really appreciate it. And I am excited about going to Kovalam and, you know, exploring life in a fishing village.
Yes.
Now, I understand even you come from a fishing village.
Yes, sir.
So, you come from Kasimedu.
Yes.
Growing up in a fishing village would have been a very different routine.
Normally, getting for 2 or 3 o'clock, we wake up and go to the sea to catch the fish. And come back with 7:30 or 7 o'clock and segregate the fish where it is and sell for this
sell
market.
Sell to the market. So you got the best of both worlds. You know fish and you also like cooking. Alright, fantastic. So let's go to Kovalam. Ready?
Ready.
Okay, let's go. Kovalam, also known as Kovalam, is a tiny fishing village located 40 kilometers south of Chennai on the East Coast Road en route to Mahabalipuram. I was looking forward to meeting my friend Selvam, a fisherman from the village. Hello Selvam.
How are you, sir?
Very
Last
fine. That's right. Good to see you again.
Wow, I'm happy to see you.
Thank you very much and thank you very much for inviting us to your wonderful...
You're almost welcome to my village, sir.
Thank you.
So this is a season for a snapper, red snapper.
Okay.
Sankara meenan solluvanga.
Okay, Sankara.
Sankara meenan.
Alright. Although it wasn't part of the original plan, Selvam asked if I'd like to accompany him on his boat. I was least prepared for this, but it wasn't an opportunity I was going to let go of. And so with my riding shoes and jacket, I embarked on a bumpy but exhilarating fishing expedition. Sitting on a tiny boat, bobbing around in the middle of the sea, is an experience that definitely helps place things in perspective. And it allowed me a little more insight into the life of a fisherman.
How far have we come in?
We are almost 3 kilometers near the house. 100 meters and 200 meters kulla ponuma.
100 meters?
That is a mud area.
Okay.
We go further in. That is a rock area. If we are going to fishing net, we are going to the bottom.
Okay.
So, we are going to the area. Okay.
If
we are going to the net, we are going to the net.
Okay.
So, we are going August, September.
Okay.
It's a good season for everything.
And when is the season not good? When is it?
April, May.
April, May.
April, May is the water temperature will be changed.
How long have you been fishing?
I am started from fishing 8 years old.
8 years old?
Yeah, with my dad.
How many years have you been fishing now?
It is almost 30 years.
30 years you've been fishing. The quantity of fish when you started 30 years ago, the amount of fish that you would catch and the amount of fish that you catch now, is there a difference?
நம்ம சொல்ல முடியாது. நம்ம இன்னைக்கு போனா நிறைய மீன் பிடிச்சிட்டு வரலாம்னு சொல்ல முடியாது.
ஓகே.
கிடைச்சாலும் கிடைக்கும்.
So some days you go out and you get fish.
Yes.
Some days you don't get anything.
Technology வந்து ரொம்ப அதிகமாயிருச்சு. We have a GPS. Suppose we இன்னைக்கு நம்ம ஒரு இடத்துல வந்து நிறைய இடத்துல நிறைய மீன் பிடிச்சிட்டோமா அதை பாயிண்ட் அடிச்சுட்டு வந்துடும். ஸோ நாளைக்கு அதே இடத்துல போயிட்டு மீன் பிடிக்கலாம். ஸோ மொபைல்ஸ் நம்ம ஃப்ரெண்டுங்க இன்னொரு யாருனாவது இன்னொரு இதுனாங்கன்னா அவங்க அந்த இடத்துக்கு போயிட்டு எக்ஸாக்டாக போய் பிடிக்கலாம். இங்கே மீன் இருக்குது வாங்க அப்படின்னு அங்கே போய் பிடிக்கலாம். லோக்கலி ஃபிஷர்மேன்ஸ் we have a community.
Okay.
Supposed to be somebody died in our village. We are not going on.
So on the days that you don't go fishing,
yes.
Whether you could, let's say because the sea is bad or something like that, the weather is rough. So what do you do then?
நம்ம ஃபேமிலியோட இருப்போம் இல்லைனா பீச்சில் உட்காந்துட்டு வலையை புதுசாக வலையை ரெடி பண்ணுவோம்
ஓகே யூ கெட் த நெட்ஸ்
நெட் ரிப்பேர் இந்த ரிப்பேர் ஒர்க் இருந்தால் அந்த ரிப்பேர் ஒர்க் பண்ணுவோம்.
ஓகே, பீங் அ ஃபிஷர்மேன் இஸ் அ டஃப் லைஃப்.
இட் இஸ் ரியலி வெரி டஃப். வருமானம் எவ்வளோ வருதோ அவ்வளோவும் செலவாக தான் இருக்கும். கடலை பற்றி நம்மளுக்கு வந்து நிறைய பேருக்கு பயம். ஆனால் லைட்டு வெளிச்சம் இல்லை, நடுக்கடலில் இருப்போம், என்ன ஆகும் ஏதாகும் யாருக்கும் தெரியாது. நாங்கள் வரது தான் தெரியும், திருப்பி போகும்போது அது கன்ஃபார்ம் தெரியாது. இப்போ வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 90% டோட்டலாக சேஞ்ச் ஆகிடுச்சு சார்.
ஓகே,
ஏன்னா வந்து நம்மளோ நம்ம கஷ்டம் நம்மளோட போயிடுவோம். ஏன்னா வந்து நம்ம கடலில் எவ்வளோ கஷ்டப்பட்டிருக்குன்னு தெரியுது, அதனால் நம்ம குழந்தைங்களுக்கு அந்த மாதிரியான ஒரு கஷ்டத்தை கொடுக்கக்கூடாதுன்னு சொல்லிட்டு நல்ல எஜுகேஷனை கொடுக்கணும்னு சொல்லிட்டு அவங்களை படிக்க நல்லா படிக்க வச்சு இப்போ பார்த்தீங்கன்னா நம்ம ஃபிஷர்மேன் இதில் வந்து நிறைய எஜுகேஷன்
கொடுத்துருக்கோம். You know, sometimes when you have to catch fish like pomfret or sea or vanjaram, you have to spend the whole night and then you come back and then you sell. There's some days that you catch a lot of fish, some days that you don't catch too much fish.
இப்ப நம்ம 10 ஃபிஷர்மேன் ஒரு இடத்துல போறாங்கன்னு வெச்சீங்களா, 10 பேருக்கும் கிடைக்காது, ரெண்டு பேருக்கு கிடைக்கும், எட்டு பேருக்கு கிடைக்காது, இல்ல அஞ்சு பேருக்கு கிடைக்கும், இல்ல அஞ்சு பேருக்கு கிடைக்காது. அந்த மாதிரி இல்ல, இன்னைக்கு இல்லனா இல்ல அவங்க கிடைச்சினா நான் நாளைக்கு நம்ம பிடிக்கலாம்ன்ற ஒரு கான்ஃபிடன்ட் இருக்கு.
Okay, so with that confidence. So I guess fishermen are probably the most optimistic people that you can probably find, right?
நம்மளுக்கு எல்லாமே தெரியும் சார், எந்த நேரத்துல எந்த காத்து அடிக்கும், எப்ப மழை பெய்யும்,
okay,
எப்ப புயல் அடிக்கும், அது எல்லாமே நமக்கு தெரியும்.
So despite all the technology, despite all those advances, I think there still is a lot of uncertainty when it comes to the life of fishermen. I think it also boils down to a lot of unpredictable factors, the ocean, the weather. And I think the ocean is everything to a fisherman. The seas are everything. And I think that's why they also call it, they refer to it as Kadal Amma, right? The sea is your mother. We've got a bounty of fish today.
I don't think I've held seafood this fresh before. It smells so beautiful. You can actually smell the ocean.
These are what they call ribbon fish, and this is what typically gets used in dried fish.
I got two of my favorite seafood here. So there's carne, and we just had shrimp. So this has been quite a fruitful expedition into the ocean. So if you look at this, we've got all this ribbon fish that they call wal locally. We've also of course got one solitary ladyfish, carne, and one shrimp. So not a bad haul.
The fishing expedition left us hungry, and Selvam said he knew just the right spot for a quick seafood snack. A fish fry shack by the beach seemed just appropriate.
So Selvam, all this looks very good. So is this locally caught, or what is?
இங்க கோவளத்துல பிடிக்கிற மீனை மட்டும் தான் இங்க சேல்ஸ் பண்றதுக்கு அலோ பண்ணு.
So which means no outside fish can come. So this is fish that is caught right here. So what are the fish that we have here?
இது வந்து நெத்திலி மீன். காணாங்கழுத்தி.
What is this?
Lady fish.
Okay, the carne.
This for mackerel.
Mackerel. I definitely want to try this chef. More of the shrimp, more the flavor. And what is this here? What is it?
இலி பூச்சின் சொல்லுவாங்க. மோல் கிராப்.
இலி பூச்சின்.
ஆமா.
மோல் கிராப்.
மோல் கிராப். இது ஆன்ஷோர்ல வந்து கேட்ச் பண்ணுவாங்க.
ஆன்ஷோர்.
Yeah, only on the shore only.
And so you eat the whole thing?
Yeah, eat the whole thing.
And I also see there's some more fish that is there. So what do we have here?
Kodua.
Sea bass. And so everything has the same masala.
Garlic. Garlic.
Malakathulu.
Chili powder.
Sola powder.
Corn flour.
Chicken masala. Okay, the chicken masala that goes into the fish masala. So let's kind of taste some of the prawn here. And we will taste also some of the mole crab. We have to taste one carne, my favorite fish. You have to approve. If you approve, that means
it's too hot.
I think before the chef, the person who caught it has to approve. How is it?
Just crunch it. Eat it all.
Mmm.
எப்படி இருக்குங்க சார்?
சோ குட். இட் காட் ஆல் தட் ஃப்ளேவர் இன் ஒன் கிரன்ச். ஐ குட் ஈட் அ ஹோல் பக்கெட் ஆஃப் திஸ். நல்லா இருக்கு. ரெடியா சார்? Very hot. It's just come off the oil.
Right, sir.
Packed with flavor. You can feel the freshness of the prawn. You get a bit of the chili, but it is not too spicy. It is not too spicy at all. You know, because I looked at the color. The color looks very spicy, very hot, but it's not. No. So whether it's crab, whether it's shrimp, or whether it's a big black pomfret. When they're ready, they all float to the top. Rumba hotel. So this black pomfret is caught in the night, usually.
Night. Predator cat is catching night time mattum pidikka mudiyum.
Okay.
The mole crab vandu low tide mattum pidikka mudiyum.
So this is caught during the low tide.
Low
the
tide.
Mole crab is caught during the low tide.
Low tide.
The pomfret is caught in the deep. So let's take a bite of the. It's still hot.
Yes.
Ah, you can see all the steam.
Taste.
Ah, lovely, lovely. This is a monster. So this is, they call it
Kalinga,
but I know this as the lady fish, the Kane. You know, one of my most favorite fish. And look at the size of this. So where does this get caught? So
you get the same neck what we are using.
Same neck. And is it in the deep or is it closer to the coast?
Within 2 kilometers.
Okay.
Kilometer plus in the middle of water.
Look at the size of this. Beautiful. How much for this fish?
80 rupees.
80 rupees. I'm going to stop going to restaurants and come to Vijay shop and eat seafood only here. This is a steal for 80 rupees. Very good. Fresh. It doesn't get fresher than this. Really, it doesn't get fresher than this. I think the fact that we're enjoying all the seafood with you, Selvam, you know, especially after having gone into the sea. And then caught some fish there, makes it even more special. It's all fresh, makes a huge difference. Delicious. In the next part of the seafood trail, I visit Selvam's home for a taste of some soul-satisfying preparations cooked by his sister-in-law, Mrs. Jayakanti. Stay tuned for more.
You know, what I really like is the fact that it's got a complete squid from the head to the tail. So the prawn tuku is finally ready and I can't wait to taste this. Even Selvam can wait to taste this. It's his favorite dish.